everyone, I'm Rena Bahamut, and welcome back to Bioshock 2. Here.
Find Eleanor, son, and fast. Her mama's got all rapture, dying to keep you two apart.
And welcome to what is pretty much the last area of the game, the Prison Persephone. Technically, there's two parts in this, and I will probably just record both of the parts in one go, but I'll probably split it up where it's most appropriate. Because there is a fairly appropriate split, I should say. And you think they actually have, like, a prison built directly into the bedrock or something like that.
Father, come quickly. I'm trapped in a cage. Something's wrong.
Despite all your rage?
I wonder, Delta, do you know why you are here? Have you any idea what my daughter has given you? As I watch you now, I envy your ignorance. You still believe.
I think that was the last weapon upgrade station in the game. I'm not entirely certain. Also, oh my gosh. Sophia Lamb almost sounds sad. It's a miracle. Well, I kind of wish like the little upgrade we just got would actually like spread open like a crossbow when I aim out like that. Not much of actual use in here, it seems. Oh hey, security bot, for free. It's an extremely easy hack. Well, this is friggin' ominous. I guess that's supposed to be Adam?
That's her, son. Eleanor Lamb. No matter what you might be feeling right now, this is business. Get that cage open. She's coming with us.
Just do some quick hacking in the area before anything goes to hell, because this smells like an encounter.
That tank she's in. Use the controls to break the quarantine seal.
Whatever you say. Son of a bitch. There we go. And that has the exact same loadout as the last one. I could probably swap out my tonics. But honestly, I don't think I really have all that great of ones to swap out for my proud parent ones. Really? Dang it.
What are you waiting for, kid?
It's called setup. Son of a bitch! There we go! Holy crap! Now do you have rocket spears? Yes! And I don't think I can really carry much of anything else. I guess heat rockets. Alright. Apparently Big Daddy can't jump.
How will she remember us after this moment? I have placed my pieces on the board, as expected, as have you. Is this what she hoped for? Mother and father, locking eyes. Yet still we are blind.
I don't see you in there, lady.
Subject Delta. And take heart, for you at least have escaped your legacy.
I have. Oh, hi there. So yes, we now actually have a boss fight against two big sisters at once. Only problem is, as you may have noticed, ooh, Drill Vampire! Drill Vampire heals you as you drill. So, let's get rid of Proud Parent. There we are. I mean, seriously, if I wanted to, I could just run over to that, whatchamadingus over there, and just buy out all the health kits I want. Where's the... Oh, there's the last one. In fact, look. Hey, I got all my fuel back. Now I can just drill you, too. Eat bees. And now that I have Drill Vampire, I can just stand and drill the entire time and not have to worry about my health at all. What? There we go. Hey, we even get some free atoms for them.
Hurry now! Quarantine chamber's waiting on you! Get in there!
Also, Eleanor's alone in there.
Look at her, Delta.
Shazam! Oh, Sophia Lamb's in there.
Still, she dreams of you.
50 seconds remain.
Do you know why Eleanor brought you here? She wanted a father. So she found a way to restore you in body and mind.
Apparently that's how the Vita chambers work. Amazing how they can replicate diving suits.
Ever since, exalting your every act as gospel. The girl lying on that bed is no longer my child, nor my life's work. She is a monster, shaped by you alone. Just as she has always wanted.
20 seconds remaining.
But there is one detail.
Such a wonderful person you are.
She failed to account for. Your body was designed to lapse into a coma when her heart ceases to beat. Eleanor, forgive me.
But her heart's still beating. Why are we still collapsing when she hasn't, yeah, done that? Also, great work with your daughter there! Parenting at its finest!
Watch it. His body is shutting down now, naturally. But if he dies of trauma, he will return elsewhere. Full restraints at all times. No one enters this room until he expires.
Well, at least she has an idea to get around the Vita chambers.
Father, it's me, Eleanor. I'm so sorry. Mother stopped my heart long enough to sever our bond. Staying near me won't stop you from dying now. Or worse. But I can still help you escape. This little sister's brought you something that will allow you to take control of her.
Okay. There's a lot more lens flare than I imagined. So, yes, we are playing as a little sister now.
This feels a bit strange, Father. But now you can see through her eyes and tell her where to go. This is how I brought you back without Mother catching on. Now, first, let's get you out of here.
I'll say this section is at least interesting in seeing how the little sisters have been conditioned to see things. Eventually we'll get into that event.
Inside Mother's office, there's a way to unlock these chambers she's holding us in. Find a way to slip in there.
That almost looks like a giant robot. Giant robots are always cool. Everything seems so nice and elegant. And really, really curtain covered. They really like the curtains, don't they? And in we go again. And I'm sure nothing creepy will come of a grown man inside a small girl's body. No creepy things at all.
You're in. There should be a lever in here somewhere. Pull it, and it will unlock our cells.
Attention! Augustus Sinclair has been sighted within the facility. He will attempt to reach Subject Delta. All family duties are hereby suspended until he is found.
So why can't I just stab her? And why is she so ignorant of us? Seriously.
What Mother did to me left me very weak. I would do this part myself. To save your life, I'm going to have to change to be like you. From here, you should be able to locate the pieces of a big sister suit. Please, bring them to me.
She says that's going to make her change, but I'm pretty sure just putting on the suit doesn't automatically make you part of it, like the Big Daddies were.
Eleanor is changing. As Delta draws closer. In her sleep, she mutters about having witnessed moments from his journey.
Daddy meets Dr. Gilbert.
She's beginning to resist the moral conditioning. Eleanor's bond with Delta is turning her from the daughter of the people back into a rebellious child whose voice I do not recognize. Worse, I suspect Eleanor of direct involvement in his return. I fear that to separate them, I may have to take measures for which I will be unable to forgive myself.
And yes, while we are a little sister, we can actually harvest dead bodies now. It's an interesting thought.
Get over here, you goddamn muppet!
Yeah, that's what I thought. You would think that... Oh, wait. Sophia Lamb would actually be trying to change the... Oh, Daddy meets Aunt Gracie. We're carrying her off. I do believe that these actually change depending upon your actions in the game.
There's a piece of the suit in here, Father. Find the rest and bring them back to me.
Oh, I found the suit. Because if, like, I kill Gracie, I would, well, be shown killing her there, I do believe.
10 years, Father. Stuck in this fever dream. Mother kept me sedated in order to perfect my mind with Adam. To her, the ideal child is a genius, serving the common good without questioning it. You have saved me from that.
Yeah, I do not agree with her common good. It seems to leave a lot of corpses around. Also, why am I not getting completely swamped by splicers while I'm trying to harvest now? Hell, why are these people not trying to mess with me? Over here we have... Okay then. Oh, that's great.
I've been quarantined, but Mother's unaware of the extent of my connections to the new little sisters. I don't just empathize with them. I can control them directly.
Kinda creepy.
They are my hands and my eyes now. Better yet, we have found Father's body and took a gene sample.
How is it not decomposed by that?
Made from me, in part. As they grow up in rapture, I feel it all. When you were with the little ones, they trusted you as their father because of me.
Okay. And good lord, I have a lot of Adam. Really make out what these were supposed to be in our dream world. And we got the big sister stabby army thingies.
Mother was right about one thing. I have been watching you, Father, studying the way you have treated others, and now I know who I am. I am free.
Uh-oh, Lamb's gone.
After everything Mother has done to me, I am alive and sane enough to be curious about the sun. When you rescued my new sisters, I felt every one. And it gave me hope for the first time in years.
Okay, how'd you put that on lying down?
Now, I will do the same for all the others, starting with this one. We've done it, Father. I'll be there soon.
Okie dokie. Oh hey, a brute! We haven't seen those in forever.
These suits always did make me think of you, Father. I guess I still remember you in shining armor. But now it's my turn to fight for you.
Why does it still sound like I'm on the radio with you? Or in my head, whatever.
Take this plasmid. You can use it to call me to your side in a fight.
Yes, we get the final plasmid and our last plasmid slot. Why is there a video for this?
Summon the big sister to fight by your side. Warning, nothing lasts forever.
Oh, I already examined all this stuff. Although, I guess I missed that.
Persephone, secret home of Sinclair Solutions. I bet against Andy Ryan's vision of harmony and rapture, offered him a quiet place to send anybody who wasn't working out, and now I'm sitting on my own private think tank. Technically, Utopia shouldn't have much use for a detention facility. But if you do business as long as I have, well, you learn to pick a brand name from the writing on the wall.
Oh my gosh, there's brutes again! Get past this. What are you saying? Things on fire, exactly.
Subject Delta, I know you can hear me. You have stolen my life's work, and with it, my only daughter. But Rapture is the house of monsters. The surface will not have us. And now, we shall be buried as a family. Side by side.
Oh, God. She's going to drop this building into the trench. It's miles deep. We have to find Sinclair.
Let every... Whoa.
The girls remember you. We...
Who are you talking to? I'm the only one here. And now we're off to inner Persephone.
Upstairs, Father. Quickly.
I would ask how you know all this, but you have been scouting out everything with the little sisters, and apparently no one pays attention to them. I don't see a "you are here" sign there.
This is Sinclair's lifeboat, Father. Out the window here. It's our only chance of escape. From what I know of Sinclair, he wouldn't just abandon it.
Yes, Delta. What of Sinclair? The man who would sell paradise. And where is he now?
I have a hunch you know.
Warning. A security curfew is now in effect. All cells and bulkheads are sealed until further notice.
Okay.
This facility hangs over an ocean trench down.
Interesting art you got on the side there.
The family has activated timed charges within its foundations. Surrender before detonation, or we shall fall and be crushed in the abyss below.
Now who's being selfish?
Mother has locked all of Persephone down, including the gangway leading to the lifeboat. We can reverse it from the holding wing if we hurry. Come on! Use the plasmid if you need me, Father.
Yes, yes, I know. Use you when I want to make the game weak.
We're going to have a look around.
Seriously, the Eleanor plasmid essentially makes the game easy street, for lack of a better word. All y'all have fun.
Or the Rapture family falls together.
What is this trickery?
You know, this is usually the point where the minions start abandoning the sinking ship. Because honestly, I don't know many people who would honestly continue fighting when you're, well, about to plummet into the ocean.
Oh, you fucker.
He got burned. And he's going spinning around on the floor. Final upgrades. Got our final health increase and all that. And finally, we can get Telekinesis 3, which is rather expensive, as you might notice. As it says, we can pick up live enemies with this. So let's skip that, we already know, because I already told us what it does. And there isn't really anything good or major when it comes to the tonics. Guess after all this time I can finally get Drill Lurker! Because that will be extremely happy at this point in time. Let's get Electro Bolt 3. And why not Winter Blast 2? Screw Hypnotize. Trying to think if we can actually get that 40 Atom for Winter Blast 3. But eh. I know, why not Decoy? What happened? Let's ditch Security Command for now. There we go. So yes, this is Decoy. I plop this down and then no one can resist trying to attack it. Oops.
You out of Rapture, Father. It's the only way I can save you now.
I already know how your saving works at the end of this. I don't know why you can't do that now, as opposed to later. You'll see what I mean.
Looks like Sinclair's been ousted. He wasn't slick enough to avoid the boot this time. But at least it wasn't a firing squad. Lamb proved she's got the ear of the general population down here. So it'd probably be prudent to play along for a while, see where this goes. She says she'll let me keep my little fiefdom here in holding, as long as I agree to help supply her therapy sessions. No qualms there. These sorry buggers could use some rehabilitation.
I hit the button.
Don't you recognize Sinclair, Delta?
Oh.
Now he is what you should have been. One final Alpha series, ready to die for the family. As Persephone's former owner, he is the ideal man to put you back in your cage.
Right.
Mother's controlling Sinclair, Father, and he's got the master key. Catch him!
That was an interesting looking key.
Kid, Lamb's in my head. I can't help myself. I have to fight just to talk. Left me my goddamn tongue to torture the bomb codes out of me. She wants me to stop you leaving. I'm sorry.
And nothing we really need now. I still have a crap ton of money left over. And where's the enemy so I can actually try to show off what this thing friggin' does? And there it is! I guess it's a nice bit of crowd control. If you want a nice little distraction. Good lord, do they love going for it. Even if they spotted me, they go for it. Yeah, the brutes are unpickable with the telekinesis. There we go. Finally got some proper shots. Oh no, you don't. Oh. Dang it, I keep on picking up something else. First, the plethora of easily telekinesable objects. Here we go. No, it might not be that much, but I find it an enjoyable way to play through the end of the game. Oh, hi there. Man, that explosion did nothing to you. Oh, chill. Wait, did I miss? Oh, come on, there we go. What? Friggin' pain in my butt. And that guy died with his kitty.
Eleanor, I know you can hear me. I am inside Sinclair's lifeboat now. Delta cannot reach me here, but you can. You need not die with him. We shall return to the surface together, if you will only step inside and accept your duty.
Remember, what happened to Rapture is a home of monsters and will never accept us?
Oh, I guess. Mother's testing me. One last game. Fortunately, by now, I'm the world's foremost expert at breaking her rules. I've made my choice, Father. And if needs be, I'll die for it.
There we go. Some of these guys don't even seem like they're really wanting to fight anymore.
Kid, I'm sorry. I've locked you in here. Lamb's making me dance on her goddamn strings. I can't stop. You're gonna have to break in here and put me down. Wish there was another way, but I'd rather die a man than live like this.
God, he's right, Father. Mother's betting you'll die in here, or that I'll abandon you before the bombs detonate. We can't save Sinclair now. We need that key from him. Find the code to the watchtower, or work out a way to draw him out.
Isn't that weird for the greediest man in the game showing off his humanity by sacrificing himself for us? Your level 3 elemental streams siphon off health from your enemies. Which is actually a pretty nice one if you enjoy using those ones. Just now that I think about it, I could... Hi there. Oh, of course. Was that a result of my zappy zap? Everybody zaps! So yes, that's the level 3 electroshock, and it also makes my hand all zappy. I don't know, I don't have a better term for it.
Son, I built this place and I did rent you out to those plasma trials up at Fontaine. And now I'm paying for it. Wish I had time to make amends. Take the lifeboat, it's all yours. Just don't leave me like this.
Of course, the question is, is Sinclair being nice now because of his whole being mind-rapied and all that stuff? Or is this just the real him coming out?
I caught a glimpse of the warden entering the code to the tower today. Last two digits were 7 and 3. Didn't catch the rest. Maybe I can just figure it out, trial and error. Wonder how long that'd take.
Maintenance tunnel, yes, I remember. That could get you near enough to lure me out. Try it, kid. Hurry.
Oh, hi there. So, yes, now Sinclair is locked in that office out there, and we have to find some way to actually, well, get in. And there's actually multiple ways to handle this. Kind of wish there was more gameplay like this, and Because, I mean, we have half the code. I could literally brute force the keypad. Oh, excuse me. Brute force the keypad. And I'm almost out of luck. Let's go to Phosphorus then.
Hey, Murphy! It's Dodge. A little baby told me you found out the warden's code. Send a message to my cell in Block 8.
Oh, come on!
Well, Delta. Eleanor's gift to you. And with each decision, you twisted her into your own image. Sinclair has no such choice. Yet in its absence, he serves the world unerringly. He,
no, he doesn't.
Is now the better man.
He's actually trying to tell me how to stop him. Anyway, back to what we were trying to listen to.
A little baby told me you found out the warden's code. Send a message to my cell in Block 8, telling me where you hid the code. And I'll consider your debts paid.
Oh, we have this with the first two digits, I do believe.
The warden's ignored my warnings for far too long. I'm taking this into my own hands. I secured a hack tool to nullify his turrets and subvert the bots. I also figured out the code. It's 2-6-4.
So now we have the whole code.
That's the full code, kid. You've done it now. Now just come on in here and put me down easy.
Seriously, how much attention is Lamb not paying to actually figure out that he is actively trying to tell me how to get around the security and break out of here?
It's time to leave this place. I held out hope for months that I'd see my family again, but it seems like this rope is my only ticket to freedom. I'm sure Ryan has seized the bookstore. No telling where Gloria and Billy will have to live. Can't seem to form a complete thought anymore. Can't sleep with that glow coming in the windows.
When you do me in, kid.
Oh my gosh.
Don't blame yourself. I won't be able to stop from trying to gun you down, but it helps to know that you're sticking to Lamb after. And let young Eleanor see the sun.
Now this one, when you're damaged by elemental attacks, you gain a small amount of Eve. It's a nice idea in theory, but think about it. How many elemental attacks do we see the enemy use? At most, we see the Houdini Splicer's fireballs. That's it. Anyway, we have the code. Now for the other method. Oh, dang it. Are you not letting me do... Oh, wait. There we go.
You're in the tunnel. Ought to give you some kind of jump on me. I hope.
Oh, yeah, that's right. My bad. Yeah, you can't actually fit through that. You're supposed to go to this turret here. I mean, not turret. Sentry. Whatever. You mess with it, and it'll flush him out.
Sinclair is moving, Father. Track him down. We need that key.
There we go. Oh, where'd you go? There you are. And now he's basically rocket launcher wielding the Alpha series. Ah, you almost made me. Stop making me almost zap you guys.
So long, kid.
Now, Father. I'm afraid that ending the lockdown means releasing all the prisoners. So please, be ready before you use that key on the override switch.
In other words, we're gonna have a whole bunch of people rushing us, so... swap to telekinesis. And it's mine time. Abandoning people when they have no further use. What did you call people like that before, Sophia Lamb? Now, what the hell do I put this into? I guess the machine gun recoil.
Override engaged. Ending security curfew. Sealing security office temporarily.
Oh no, whatever will we do?
Sinclair died a hero of the Rapture family, Delta. Was he a friend to you, or just a tool? Can you even grasp the difference?
Can you?
And Eleanor, you have chosen Subject Delta over your mother, your people, and the duty of your birth. So be it. You believe this craft will carry Delta to safety. Like a spoiled child with a new toy. I have no choice but to take it away.
Curfew lifted. All cell blocks open. All bulkhead sealed.
That looks like I killed a few of these guys.
Oh no. Mother's turned her attention to the lifeboat. We must go there, now!
Alright. Well, I guess I'll just follow the... the arrow. Let the drone handle that. Hi! Meet my bees! Why are you all red?
Obsession will end her.
Well, also your daughter obsession.
Before you die, I will take all that you hold dear. Sinclair is just another body in your wake.
I swear, everything she says could easily just be turned right back onto her. Now why can't I headbutt people? And now clearly we have to hurry! Hi. Okay. And we're done with that section and we're on to what is pretty much the finale. Oh no, but something blew up.
I was afraid of this. Mother has bombed out the ballast compressors, Father. The lifeboat will be too heavy to launch. Unless... let me think. I think I can boil away the water and get the lifeboat to rise. But I can't generate that much heat alone. It's time to recruit the rest of Mother's little sisters. We're taking them with us. Head to the pediatric wards.
Okay. So yes, our final mission is to... Oh. Free... Whoops. Ah, dang it. is to free all the little sisters so that we can boil some water to get the lifeboat out.
I won't let her take you from me again, Father. Hold on.
So yes, now we get to go through the therapy wings. It's kind of hard to try to be creepy at this juncture. I mean, we're supposed to be in the middle of our, oh god, run, and you expect us to slow down and take in some ambiance?
Mother's people are starting to detonate the charges. We don't have long.
Oh, hi there. Apparently I missed. And we have ourselves a key code, which is actually entirely optional for some stuff. I think that's the hint for it.
With this damn faulty memory of mine, I need to record a clue so I don't forget the key code. Brown legs, red mouths, blue arms, green eyes. Now to secure this lock somewhere.
So, four legs. I think 1, 4, 6. Booyakasha. For yet another safe.
He raised me to echo him, but to model as it was to be.
Really?
I was a teacher of a simple moral calculus. Each choice as though the world must bear it. For the common.
Wait, do they actually still see me? And I can't even see the bot. There it is. Screw this. Screw it all. Okay, so yes, that's all that little puzzle was to get us.
Yet the word means both good place and no place. We refuse to believe. And yet, we will forever seek utopia. Driven always to want more, no matter how much we have.
I'm really not entirely certain what she said there. It's extremely difficult to listen to someone rant off about utopia when you're in the middle of trying to gun down a bunch of people. There's a metaphor somewhere. Well, somehow I got that one right.
Think I will smile. Congratulations. Just experience.
Oh yes, this is wonderful therapy. Zapping people with electricity while showing them a sexy lady.
And act as such. The illusion begins to break down. Your genes.
We're almost to the pediatric ward. I expect we'll be fighting our way inside.
Is part of the program. I submit the following conclusion. The gene is the enemy.
She keeps on saying that the genes are the enemies. But what do my pants have to do with anything? Okay, yeah, that was a terrible joke. My gosh. You know, I've been to a psychiatrist before. You don't need to know why. But I don't remember them sticking me in these kind of conditions.
Hello, Mother. As you've always said, I shouldn't be allowed to wander the city in my condition. But without going outside, it's harder to hear much about the world. So I'm learning at home. This, I think, is a porcelain tea service in the style of Louis XV. Isn't that right? Now that's a fascinating sound. And this is called a stained glass window. Handcrafted by your adoring flock. They've gone to a lot of trouble to capture your likeness, haven't they?
Sounds like Eleanor went a little bit crazy when she got loose. Definitely not gonna knock her from sticking it to Lamb. It also sounds like she was having a few issues with Eleanor before I came back around. I hear something big moving around, like one of the office areas. And my controller's shaking like one of them's around too. Seriously, my controller shakes whenever one of them... Whoa. And that's an expensive buyout. You know what? He gave me a crap ton of those, so why not abuse them? Oh, looks like three auto hag darts. Looks like a whole bunch of the alternate ammos. Okay, where are you? This is starting to annoy my hands. Oh, almost killed in one shot. Did I just lock him up because of the decoy? Sure looks like it. Let me activate the diary. There we go.
Need I remind you, Sinclair, that Lamb is your problem now. She's no longer a citizen of Rapture. That was the proviso. Wanted her expertise, and now you have it. Ryan Industries is your client, and we require test candidates from among your charges. The protectors are short-lived. Lamb would be a messiah, correct? Well, sell her a sacrifice to save the flock.
So what? Sinclair wanted her as his prison counselor? Go have fun with that. Pretty sure there's, yep. Really? With that.
It isn't safe to begin yet. We must finish off the splices first.
Oh, fine.
When you've cleared them out, I'll need a signal. Push the call button on the window there, and then I'll proceed.
You just told me that. There it is.
Cannot hide. Too hard.
Press the kill button.
Come on.
seriously, Telekinesis 3 is awesome. But they just wait so late in the game to get it. Well. What do I care about hacking that? I've got more than enough money. And you get hit on fire. Multiple times. Have fun with the decoy. Oh, these are elite brute splicers. So even without little sisters to protect, I still have to protect little sisters.
I'll wake the children up. They're stronger than they know. With their help, I should be able to boil off the water and get us all out of here. Go on ahead, Father. I'll free them as quickly as I can, just as you showed me.
Oh, I do get Adam out of that, huh?
You are not saving them, Delta. No matter how pure your intent, the surface is not paradise, but perdition.
And what do you call this place?
I'd sooner see them drown.
Look, Father, I know you may not have wanted a daughter, but love is just a chemical. We give it meaning by choice. I will be damned if I let Mother take you away from me again. The plasmid, Father. Just point the way and I'll help you fight.
I thought you were busy with the little sisters. Where are you trying to point me to, Yang? Oh, this way. Not sure why that doctor suddenly decided he had to light that corpse on fire.
That's another charge gone. We have to keep moving. If this building falls, we're all dead.
You get over here and say hi to your friends for me.
What is this trickery?
That done. Although I wonder why they put these pediatric wards in such different spots of the building. I mean, we have one here in the infirmary and another in that administration area.
Eleanor was to be a composite of all Rapture's genius. The first living utopian.
You keep using that word. I don't think it means what you think it means.
Regard for herself. To force consciousness on such a being is to tear its wings away. That was your gift to her, Delta. Just as she hoped. You must be very proud.
Yep.
Delta was in top form today. The guards tried to make him take another dose of whatever the hell it is they're pumping into him, and he managed to take on all four of them at once. Snapping legs and arms, blood everywhere. They say one of the guys might not even wake up. I wish I could be that free.
Steady, Father. Don't let go now.
They kind of missed an opportunity making
wake
the...
up! Why don't you wake up?
I don't know. Maybe they're tired, man.
I will not lose!
Yeah, I don't care about whatever stupid adventure you're having here. You can't try to force scary events like this when you're in a desperate rush to escape scenario. Sorry, it just doesn't work.
I will offer no insight.
Not even my good old shotgun is doing that much damage. But the shock effect is still taking, well, effect. I wonder if that turret will actually destroy itself before it can hack it. Let's see. Ah, oh, crap. The decoy vanished first. Well, apparently it's din-din time. Well, hey, one of them's actually ignoring the decoy. With that little... Whoa! I'm not entirely sure where he was going! Give me your first aid kit. I don't care anymore. Apparently that alpha was sitting in here with this guy. And more phosphorus bug, auto hack dart. Seriously, you'd think they'd at least give me like a timer to that would say, oh shit, we're all dead now. There's another power to the people station in here.
Dr. Lamb, she explained how my cravings for control were rotting me out from the inside. We found all these incidents in my log where I made it easy for a convict to get the jump on me. Just so I could bloody punish him. Christ. But I believe I could do some good down here now. With the family. Well, we have a shot at surviving that fucking bedlam going on up there. Maybe even take the city back.
Okay, why not? I'm going the wrong direction, aren't I? Yep, I've been going the wrong direction. I'm supposed to go upstairs, apparently. Well, who's performing the whole little sisters, procedure on these people? When it seems like all the doctors are bad shit crazy. I mean, usually when you go nuts, you can't handle extremely precise procedures, as I imagine sticking a slug in a little girl and making sure she survives it would be.
Managed to dart past the nurse today and throw herself over the railing in the lobby. Not certain if she was trying to end her own life or merely escape. Either way, her legs had healed by the time I managed to get down to the first floor where she lay. Now, without a proper setting, the rapid healing process had fused her bones back together at odd angles. We had to re-break and set them almost a dozen times, each due to the small window of viability. Now, those children may be immortal, but I can verify they feel pain. Advising Dr. Lamb on higher doses of sedatives to keep this from happening again.
All for utopia.
Wait. Go on!
I'll just let me shoot you already.
Yeah.
Seriously, nothing's really a threat by this point. I can play as reckless as I want. Nothing's really gonna stop me. I guess, yeah, if I was playing on a harder difficulty, I'd have to be more careful at some point. But at this point, I got all the damage reduction tonics. I've got my guns upgraded to be awesome. I've got all my plasmids. I've got my well, I already said my tonics. I can set up traps anywhere I want. I can control fights however I want. There's nothing really scary here.
My first incarnation when Dr. Lamb gave me my mandate to alleviate pain was to block his neural pathways. Now, the preliminary results were promising too, until some of the children started chewing their own tongues off out of ignorance. Need to sequester them away from the others so as not to cause undue stress on the remaining subjects.
You know, Sophia Lamb, I'm pretty sure that the other little sisters had better than these ones. Holy shit.
Father, get ready.
Yep. How did you do that? I'm guessing he came running at me from down the stairs over there, but... What?
When you've cleared them out, I'll need a signal like before. Push the call button, and I'll proceed.
Why can't I just use the summon you plasmid? Oh no, all the splicers are coming, whatever will I do? Am I even needed here? Stop running away and teleporting. Oh, you're up there. Keep on grabbing their stupid fireballs. Oh, she killed herself on the dummy. There we go. Finally managed to grab one of you dudes. Oh, where am I getting hit from? Oh, you. To find our little... So why do you need me to call you if you're just gonna sit right there?
I think... Yes, we're ready for the ballast tank. I can boil off the water and get us out of here. We must return to the docking platform, Father, now.
You granted Eleanor the will to choose. And now, like a plague, she spreads it to those innocents.
Yes, yes, consciousness is a disease and you are the cure.
You are damning them.
Where did you get this idea in your head exactly? Come on!
I'm stepping inside the ballast tank, Father. Come up to the glass once you're ready for me to begin. There's no going back once we start.
Apparently, all little sisters can teleport now. Good to know.
You would rip my only daughter from her home and family and feed her to a world without hope. Though Utopia may die with her, I would sooner see us fall. Goodbye, Eleanor.
Good Lord, you've already said this like 5 times!
Here they come, Father! Hold them off until I can bring it to a boil.
Yep. The finale of this game is another survive for a while someone does something else. I guess it's kind of fitting. It's kind of how this whole game has gone. Everyone pay attention to that.
You won't get any better that way.
Nearly boiling.
Even this whole section has been made easy because we can still summon Eleanor. I've been purposely not using her. But seriously, I can just summon her, sit back, and do nothing for the entire fight. Oh, and ain't you just a fine example of AI? Yes, yes, yes. Oh. I already have you out. Yes, poor brutes. This is truly a challenge for the ages. Everything's dead. We must hurry.
The elevator to the lifeboat is flooded, Father. We have to equalize the pressure in here or the... We've done it, Father. We're launching. Get to the elevator.
And to make things even easier, while you're running for the way out, they put us underwater so nothing else can actually fight.
The bombs, Father! We're falling! Run!
Hurry! There's no tension in this section! Oh, please, I've tanked harder things than that to my face. So, yeah, we still make it onto the lifeboat, surviving that explosion to the face. And we're still fine. So, what was the point of that explosion? Bye, Rapture. You were awesome in the first game. I imagine the G-forces as this thing rushes to the surface would be rather intense.
And then, Father, the Rapture dream was over. You taught me that evil is just a word. Under the skin, it's simple pain. For you, mercy was victory. You sacrificed, you endured, and when given the chance, you forgave.
How are you not exploding from the pressure difference as we rise?
Mother believed this world was irredeemable, but she was wrong, Father. We are Utopia, you and I. And in forgiving, we left the door open for her.
And Sophia Lamb lives in this ending.
The Rapture dream is over, but in waking, I am reborn. This world is not ready for me, yet here I am. It would be so easy to misjudge them. You are my conscience, Father, and I need you to guide me.
So we get absorbed by Eleanor and live on in our teenage daughter's body. Well, technically not. Nothing creepy about that at all.
Be with me now, Father. Your memories, your drives. And when I need you, you'll be there on my shoulder, whispering.
Sophia Lamb in this ending, exactly.
If Utopia is not a place, but a people, then we must choose carefully, for the world is about to change. And in our story, Rapture was just the beginning.
Or not, because your story did not continue any further. And Lord knows, I think I would remember if around World War II era, we suddenly had people running around flinging fireballs and all that fun stuff. And that's Bioshock 2. I'd say more here, but I'll leave that for post-recording me to do, so that's a lot more coherent as I try to ramble out my angry thoughts. But for now, I'm Riona Bahamut, and I'll just leave it for the other guy to start talking now. See you all next time, when we play the really good one. Bioshock 2 has ended, and thank God for that. I will admit I was getting pretty salty at the end there, but the game really wasn't helping me that much. On a whole, the game has a major case of sequelitis. The plot is pretty similar, and you can easily directly compare the major characters to their Bioshock 1 counterparts. Sophia Lamb is a reverse-gendered Andrew Ryan with a seemingly bigger ego and less backstory. Sinclair is basically a greedy Atlas who, in a slight twist, decides to help you kill him at the end. Whether this was due to Lamb's mindfuckery or not is debatable. And Eleanor is pretty much your Tenenbaum slash Proto-Elizabeth. The gameplay is essentially unchanged, with a few fun upgrades to some of the plasmids, but the guns are essentially the same, with a texture swap aside from some ammo variation. Which is a shame, because one of the big selling points was you were going to be a big daddy. Except you don't feel any different than playing Jack, outside of a couple small differences like the drill and spear gun. Not sure how I've fixed that. I just think there isn't a real sense of power and weight that the Big Daddies generally give off in their giant, lumbering, earth-shaking steps. The inclusion of online multiplayer was a decent idea and kind of fun, and surprisingly, it's still up and semi-active. At time of writing this, I just tested it out and was able to get into a game of Capture the Sister pretty quick. Now, the idea of playing as a Big Daddy and protecting a little sister isn't the worst of ideas. Unfortunately, they built the entire game around a hold-the-position game style, rather than focusing on exploration, which I feel was one of Bioshock 1's strengths. Now, when you get a little sister, basically all progression stops until you find two bodies and sit around for a bit, and that heavily disrupts the game's flow. Sure, you can just harvest/rescue them immediately, but some of the roadblocks that get thrown at us are pretty bad as well. Dionysus Park is pretty much go get the little sisters because we say so or no game progression for you. Friggin' Fontaine Futuristics has two locked doors. One is old because we can't blow up a security drone for no good reason, and the second is to feed Sophia Lamb's giant goldfish. Heck, Alexander the Great could have been a cool boss fight instead of some strange blob in a tank we probe. Also, don't get me started on that thud of a finale. Instead of some epic confrontation, we get a swarm of minions that I can easily breeze through and the player does not get any form of actual choice, closure, or confrontation with Lamb herself. It's entirely based on your ending. Admittedly, your choices throughout the game are meant to be shaping Eleanor, and she has as much right to revenge or forgiveness as we do. But that kind of gives the player blue balls, even if we went all out evil and Eleanor kills Lamb at the end. Speaking of whom, Sophia Lamb really doesn't work as a good villain and is kind of the breaking point for me. She is a smug, condescending bitch with such a big hypocrite it isn't even funny. I don't know if that is supposed to be the point, but all it does is piss me off when she claims moral superiority while acting exactly like or worse than Andrew Ryan. It's pretty hard to argue that she isn't everything she claimed Andrew Ryan was. A tyrant who does not care about anyone other than themselves and their ambitions, and callously tosses aside anyone who wasn't worth anything to them. Take the people in Pauper's Drop. Why are they still living down in the slums? Lord knows the swanky parts of town are full of vacancies now, so why does Lamb have them stay in the shittiest part of Rapture? Hell, it's not even an attempt to spare the sane non-splice people because Grace still lives there. She doesn't even have a leg to stand on when debating about the fate of Rapture. Andrew Ryan did because he built the damn place, so him thinking he had a controlling interest in the city made sense. Sophia? She thinks her viewpoint is superior because she is superior, and that's her entire motivation. At one point she claims she knows the surface and that it is a terrible place. But that doesn't really answer the question of where did she get this belief system. This game really needed some kind of morality pet for Sophia Lamb. Something to show she treats some of her people well and that she actually has a leg to stand on in her arguments. She needs to actually try to protect and help her family for anyone to take her seriously. Actually see her trying to have a utopia down there that we actually mess up. Or some attempt at least where she has people she wants to protect and care about. Instead, she makes Grace trap us, which almost ended in her death. She sends wave after wave of splicers in a pointless struggle because we are immortal due to the Vita chambers, and she clearly knows this given how she tries to finish us off in Persephone. She floods Siren Alley as a stupid show of power, killing hundreds of her followers for no reason. She opens the security door so we can take her proxy revenge against Stanley. She performs hundreds of inhumane experiments in Fontaine Futuristics and turns Gilly Alexander into a crazy blob monster that she gives full rein to kill people whenever he wants. And then she smothers her own daughter with a pillow to kill her father. I don't sympathize with her. I don't like her. I don't think I could have a decent conversation with her. I consider her a worse person than Andrew Ryan, because even though he did bad things and became what he hated, at least he showed some regret for his action. At least he could see that he was doing horrible things. Sophia Lamb could kill someone without a second thought and think it was perfectly justified for her empty utopia. Because what is utopia when it's built on the corpses of its opponents and turns everyone into prisoners in their own bodies? Sounds like hell to me. I'm Rion of Bahamut, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you all in the skies of New York, Columbia.
Where am I?